What's up, guys? It's me, Dan, the Film Jet, and it's about 1 week since, you know, what happened in Missouri. No, not Kansas City, as everyone likes to get confused. So yeah, our season's over. It's been over since last week, and I know we're all still mourning the loss of the season last week. Oh, geez, it was bad. I'm sure some of you saw my short with my friend. We were just hanging out, chilling out, having a good time. You know, it was cool beans, you know. At some point, you know, people want to ask me, like, whether, you know, the season was great, whether it was not, whether it was, like, very mediocre. I mean, it was fun. Don't get me wrong. We saw a lot of good. We saw a lot of bad. We saw a lot of inconsistencies as well in certain points of the team. But overall, it was fine. I'll give you my opinion. What's the season... Did the season end bad or good? I would say yes and no that this was a failure. And I would say yes because, you know, last year we were injured. Most of our players were injured. Even Tua was missing games. Our receivers were out as well. I think Waddle was out as well. And even Skyler had a huge game. Well, not really. Just to get us into the playoffs last year. And also to face off Buffalo. And we snuck up in there somehow, you know. And this year, I would say I guess the only good thing I can say about this year is we doubled the record, because last year was 8 wins, or yeah, no, it was 9-8, and then we won 11 games this year because Tua was able to stay on the field. That was like one of my biggest criticisms for Tua this season, his endurance and his chance to, you know, be productive at least. And he did it, man. He did it. Sure, our record was a little bit better. You know, it could have been a little bit better had we won those games at the Titans or the Ravens. Well, Ravens seemed impossible, or the freaking Bills, man. I know, right? You know, and I think Chris Greer just said that Tua might get an extension, or he might pick up his fifth year option, which, okay, but, and this is not a knock on Tua. So if anyone's gonna come in the comments saying like, "Oh, you're a Tua hater, you're a Tua hater, you're a Tua hater," let me finish before you yap. Shh. I would say. No, pretty much, because I would rather him. He's already completed like my agenda for this season, that he was able to play like all 18 games, even in the playoff game, which is, yeah, good. He was able to help the team out, able to help put the team in the good position to win half the time, and he put up I wouldn't say MVP numbers, but he still put up pretty good numbers for this season to actually make us, you know. To root for the guy, basically. My problem is, based on one from last week, I would say no, because he has to keep that same consistency going into the postseason, and he was not able to do that. Now, I'll be fair. There are some throws that he can make. I'm not saying he can't, but he can definitely make some of those throws, especially that beautiful big bomb to Tyreek. A lot of people said it was like a bad throw, but I kind of didn't see it as such. I mean, granted, it was it kind of did come up a little bit behind Tyreek. I don't know. I have to look at that play again just to see what everyone's talking about. I mean, that was like the only good play of that whole game. The thing is, I don't really care about individual numbers. I mean, breaking the records, like, oh, Tua getting Tyreek getting 2,000 yards to break the record from Calvin Johnson, I think. I'm like, okay, cool. Like, I don't understand. I don't care about that. Just continue going on to the season. Half the defense did step up. I mean, I get that everyone's a bit disappointed with Vic Fangio this season. Granted, yeah, it did take some time for him to get used to this whole new template in South Florida. He didn't do a bad job, but he didn't do a marvelous job. But he was able to, you know, conjure up a good, decent enough defense. But I mean, it's not what Boyer did, which I probably have to be a Josh Boyer apologist. Yeah, I was one of the ones who were just like claiming for Josh Boyer to leave, to go away. And Fangio, a little bit better than Boyer, I guess. I don't know. I mean, that's kind of debatable, really. But, you know, and there was a lot of great great players on the defense as well. Well, not a lot, but a good chunk of a good portion of it. You know, sure, we had Christian Wilkins, you know, totaling his sack total. Zeeler. Oh my God, he's been killing it the last couple of years. Raekwon, not so much. I haven't heard great things about him. Who else? And Ogba has been vanishing like these past year, or this year at least, from what I've noticed. Van Ginkle, oh boy. Everyone calls that boy Thor, but I call him Clay Matthews 2.0. He's got the hair. He's got that body language. Maybe not the toughness as Clay Matthews, but I think he's a good comparison in some capacity. But he's like the only one of the linebackers that's been dominant this season. And Jalen Phillips has been sort of like a former shell of himself. He hasn't been getting that much of continuity from last year. It does suck to see him go down with that horrible, horrible injury in the Giants' place. Not the Giants, Jets. What else? Oh, yeah, and Kader Kohou. I've given him the benefit of that doubt, but the dude's not been the same player. Like, he's shown you why he went undrafted in his class. The guy has just been leaving people open, making space, kind of like going on inconsistent routes, looking lost out there. Like, I don't know what it is about him this year. I don't know if he's confused about Fangio's playbook, or maybe he's not understanding what Fangio is trying to do with these, like, audibles, or not audibles, but I don't know, or man coverage, you know, or dropping back to coverage. I don't know, it's weird. Like, I'm good, and I know there's going to be some people like, oh, trade Kohou, he's bad, he's trash, blah, blah, blah. Yeah, it was a down year for him, but I like to keep it consistent where I like to keep it. I like to keep players that are drafted or undrafted 3 years to at least show me something. And since, you know, it was a bad sequel for Kader, I'm going to give him another year. I'm going to give him another year to, you know, finally get what Fangio is like incorporating to him, like what Fangio is cooking up in the kitchen, basically. The offensive line was decent. I know a lot of people, you know, just get on Chris Greer about the whole, like, offensive line. Oh, he's bad offensive line. And I'm just like, I'm sorry, did you guys not see Kendall Lamb and Austin Jackson and Robert Jones, even though he's a little bit inconsistent? Well, not really, but... And Eichenberg, who, you know, everyone, including me, crapped on Eichenberg whenever he plays. But the dude's... He's getting better, but he's not a finished product. He's not great. But he's decent. He's starting to get it together. Granted, yeah, some of it can have past piss poor back blocking. Oh my God, I'm going all over the place. And Eichenberg is a decent center. I mean, I know Connor Williams. You know, I know we like to harp on Connor Williams with the bad snaps, but Eichenberg, he's done a little bit worse with the snaps, in my opinion, this season than what Connor's been doing. But overall, you know, the offensive line, for the most part, has been able to, you know, approve of at least a decent part of the season. Like, if we're all gonna stand by Tua, then we gotta stand by with the offensive line as well. You know, half the time it could be look bad, decent, good, something like that. And you gotta credit Butch Berry. I know we all trashed Butch Berry when he came down here, and I just kind of gave it the benefit of the doubt. I wanted to see how it goes. I just wanted to see how he would. How his wisdom would pick up on some of these other young guys. So it was just Armstead. He's old. Like Robert Hunt. Like, he's having a fantastic year as well. Even Isaiah Wynn before he went down with that horrible injury. Which, you know, praying that he's getting better. It was a decent season. And what do I look for in this offseason is try to move some players around. Like, a lot of people say that Christian Wilkins might be leaving, and I'm willing to believe that, but part of me is simply thinking that maybe there's something that they could, that the front office can work out, that McKenzie, Greer, and some of the other, or Tom Garfinkel can figure out with Wilkins. I think this might be his last game, but you never know. Look at Van Ginkle from last year. Remember, he was about to head out. Go to the Patriots, and then they're like, they gave him a phone call, like, "Hey, Andy, come here, we got something for you. Get here. We're gonna go all in. We're putting the chips all in for you this year, buddy." And what happens? So it's like I'm not saying the predictions are wrong. I'm just saying that, yes, I still think that Wilkins can walk away, since the price tag was like way too much for Greer to pay him, especially when that was kind of a warning sign when last year they paid Sealer over Wilkins. And I don't know. Well, I guess we'll see. And for the draft, I think it says that we have the 21st pick in the first round. I would say either go for offensive line or defensive line, or safety. I feel like no one's talking about safety as well. No shot at Deshaun Elliott or Javon Holland. They're all wonderful. They're all amazing. They're good guys. They're good guys on the field half the time. But I feel like you know you need at least another safety. Maybe not in the first round, but that's just a hypothetical. But I do think you need to draft the offensive lineman that can pick up after Teron Armstead goes out, like how Kendall Lamb did. Now I don't know if we're gonna keep Kendall Lamb. I'm sure we are. I think he's under contract. But there's too many questions, and I know people want to start to blame on Chris Greer, which is fair. But at the same time, you know, Chris Greer doesn't call it the plays. Chris Greer doesn't call play action. Chris Greer doesn't play defense. Chris Greer doesn't tell these guys what to run. Or Chris Greer didn't make Tua, force that pass before the 2-minute warning in the Ravens game. But you see what I'm getting at? Like, if you're gonna go at Chris Greer, you gotta also go at the coaching. And I'm not just saying not just McDaniel, but some of the assistant coaches, the offensive coordinator, the defensive coordinator, linebackers, receivers, Welker. You know, it's like Austin Clark. Here's hoping it's a better offseason this year, because I know a lot of people weren't too happy with the Cam Smith pick. I mean, hopefully he plays this year. Maybe not. I would love to see Channing Tindall get some playing time. I'm not mad. I'm not too mad about it, but I'm going to be cracking jokes up about this team because I love them at the end of the day. I crack jokes up to my friends as well, so because I like them. But this does need to have some changes. Not a whole lot, but a major change needs to happen. Now, whether it happens or not, I don't know for sure. But we'll see what happens. That's about it for the video. If you like this, subscribe, comment down, hit the like button, do whatever you want to do. And let's hope it's a good offseason, Dolphin fans. Just hang in there. I know we're all still depressed about the season ending. But there's a lot more football to go on with the playoffs if you're interested in that. All right. Have a good night, and let's go Dolphins, and let's go Heat.